Well, hello everyone. Hope you had a nice Thanksgiving, and I have a little snack for you. We have Tim Anderson, Managing Director of TJM Investments. Hi, Timothy. Thank you for taking
the
time.
It's so great to be with you today.
I've been counting down the days for this to happen, so I can't wait to talk markets with you. Tim, is this a Black Friday rally?
Well, it's at least a little bit of a relief rally. I mean, the market was just bludgeoned from every direction last week and a little bit the week before, and it was obviously, it's been a very difficult month. But I think things got a little bit extreme on the downside, certainly with the decline in oil. Over the last couple of weeks was a very heavy weight on the market. That got exacerbated a little bit on Friday, even though it was only a half day for stocks. And as much as people will talk about how lower oil prices and lower gas prices are like a tax cut for the consumer, they can say that till they're blue in the face. It didn't work that way in 2015. Sure, the consumer has a few more bucks in their pocket, but the much bigger effect is that every company that's connected to the oil industry in any way, shape, or form really gets hurt if we start to see lower prices like we eat to the extent that we did 3 years ago.
So, Tim, can you tell me why is oil up today, given all the bearish factors?
Look, I think that there's a little bit of a relief rally going on in oil. I think that almost everybody, professionals as well as traders, totally misplayed the Iran sanctions trade that about a month and a half ago. Okay? And really, oil peaked. The two big things that have driven the market to the downside over the last 2 months were Fed Chairman Powell's speech on October 2nd or 3rd, when he was much more hawkish than the market had expected. And oil peaked within 2 or 3 days of the beginning of October and started a decline, and that's when a lot of people were talking about $100 oil is right around the corner. So it was when it became clear that that was not going to happen, everybody was positioned the other way. They fought it a little bit. They thought at one point, okay, we've been down 4 or 5 weeks, now we're going to hold. And then we had this trade in the market where a lot of hedge funds or professional oil traders were long oil and short nat gas, and then they just got pounded on both sides of that trade.
Yeah, that was pretty ugly. Now, that's going to be a discussion on Friday, oil, of course, at the G20 summit, sure, along yep. with trade. What are your expectations out of that?
I think that the market expectations are anything that it's a no-lose scenario at this point. Because people have been saying, oh, the U.S. and China, they're drifting further apart. They've got unresolvable issues. They're not going to get a deal done. They're you know, a long ways away from resolving the intellectual property issue and the trade issue. And so I think that anything that, at the worst, it's a neutral event, and and the positive effect might be that all of a sudden some real progress comes out of nowhere, which has happened before with Trump and all of his little trade manipulations, and the market could get a relief rally. Some of that might be going on today, okay? And so I think that the market, there's is much more likely to react positively to the G20 than negatively.
And Tim, you say that with a lot of conviction. I like that.
Look, if we rally 1,000 points between now and Friday, that could change a little bit, okay? But I just think that the market had discounted in a worst-case scenario from that as of the end of last week.
Well, our viewers are going to be so happy that we have you finally on the show. Tim, we hope to see you again, and thank you for taking the time out of your busy day to talk to us.
Oh, you're more than welcome. It's been a pleasure.